questions about American schools. Press Secretary Sarah Sanders was pressed on what the president himself thought about DeVos's interviews, ranging from school choice to arming teachers. Here's Sanders.
That's the focus of the president, not one or two interviews, but on actual policy that can help protect the safety and security of school kids across this country. I'm not sure if he saw the whole thing or not.
Oh, Tom Foreman is out front.
Have the public schools in Michigan gotten better?
I don't know. I have not intentionally visited schools that are underperforming.
Maybe you should.
Maybe I should. Yes.
The secretary did not have many answers about schools in her home state, but she could not miss the coast-to-coast uproar over her interview. In the headlines, embarrassing, DeVos face-planted. On social media, is this a freaking SNL skit? And on TV.
I'm sorry. That is the biggest train wreck of an interview I've seen in a long time.
Kind of painful.
She didn't do a homework.
What went wrong? Consider her response to the persistent protest from some students at that Florida high school where a gunman killed 17 people.
They want gun control.
They want a variety of things. They want solutions.
Or how about the moment she drew an equivalency between a false rape
there
report and rape itself?
One sexual assault is one too many, and one falsely accused individual is one too many.
Yeah, but are they the same?
I don't know.
DeVos, who was confirmed by a single vote, has long been under fire from congressional Democrats. Some who even suggested the billionaire bought her job with massive donations to Republicans.
Everyone. I have heard the number was $200 million. Does that sound in the ballpark?
Collectively, between my entire family? That's possible.
Betsy, you can't hide.
But protesters have also raged about her defense of charter schools, vouchers, and her stiff criticism of the public school system. Students erupted when she said historically black colleges were early advocates of school choice, seemingly ignoring the racist policies that made them a necessity. And of course, there was that infamous moment when she suggested, falsely, that schools in Wyoming might
probably
be armed.
I would imagine that there's probably a gun in the school to protect from potential grizzlies.
So perhaps it's inevitable this question also came up.
Why have you become, people say, the most hated cabinet secretary?
I'm not so sure how exactly that happened.
Many political analysts are not exactly sure how this interview happened either, despite the fact that DeVos went in a belated tweet barrage, taking the Donald Trump playbook to go after 60 Minutes. The bottom line is this was a reset, something to try to get the public back on her side. Many political analysts are saying it failed. Aaron?
All right, Tom, thank you very much. And out front now, national affairs correspondent for The Nation, Joan Walsh. Former Republican senator from Pennsylvania, Rick Santorum, joins us. Also, Senator, good to have you back. Let me start with you. Betsy DeVos, is she qualified for the job?
Sure, she is. You know, Betsy DeVos, I mean, I listened to that interview and the criticism about the questions about her role in Michigan. The reality is Betsy DeVos was not the Secretary of Education in the state of Michigan. She was a philanthropist. She was somebody who was a promoter of charter schools and someone who did an excellent job in actually making charter schools available to kids who were in failing schools and holding those charter schools accountable. 22% of charter schools in Michigan have been defunded and basically ended because they were not performing well. No traditional public schools have been ended during that same 10-year period. The reality is she has been an advocate for reform of giving poor children the opportunity to get a quality education.
Joan.
She's been the advocate. Michigan has more for-profit charter schools than anywhere else, and they are the ones that have been judged subpar compared to the nonprofit charter schools.
Not true.
Absolutely true.
Not
it's in
true.
The Washington Post. It's absolutely
it's not
true. They have been found to be more
wrong.
Subpar.
You can't, you're entitled to your opinion, not your
it's
facts.
Not,
That's
it's
false.
Not an opinion. Read the Washington Post. Read the Detroit Free Press.
There have been several studies done in Michigan. All of them
the
have shown fall, that
the
these,
for-profit
that these,
schools
that the charter
are worse
schools
than the nonprofit charter
the
schools.
Schools.
I'm talking about the for-profit charter schools. And there are more for-profit charter schools, thanks to Betsy DeVos, than in any other state. The $1 billion of Michigan public money is going to charter schools in Michigan, and that is thanks to her advocacy. The idea that she does not have the responsibility to know the test scores are declining in Michigan, that Michigan schools are in trouble after this being her life work and why she got this job in addition to all the money she gave Donald Trump.
She was asked,
ludicrous. That was a shameful interview,
Senator,
and she should be fired.
Senator, yeah, let me ask you about that interview, though. There were some moments in it, and I watched the whole thing, too, that were cringeworthy, and you may have felt the same way. One of them was this one, when she was asked explicitly by Leslie whether she had visited schools in Michigan that are struggling, right, to figure out what the problems are. And I just want to replay that exchange one more time.
Have you seen the really bad schools? Maybe try to figure out what they're doing?
I have not intentionally visited schools that are underperforming.
Maybe you should.
Maybe I should, yes.
Look, I mean, yeah, obviously Leslie backed her into a corner and she bobbled the answer. But the reality is this.
But that shouldn't be backing into a corner. Senator, if I asked you if you had gone to schools, you would tell me yes.
Yeah, the answer is, did she go to school specifically because they were poorly performing schools? And the answer was, well, no, I didn't go specifically. That doesn't mean she hasn't been to those schools. She just didn't go because they're poor performing schools. And I go back to the point that she isn't.
Well, what she said is I have not intentionally visited schools that are underperforming.
She wasn't the Secretary of Education. She was there to try to create an opportunity for charter schools so those poor performing schools, of which you just referred to, Michigan has, the public schools are in not very good shape, and that's one of the reasons she pushed for charter schools, to give children an opportunity to get better education, and those charter schools are performing better than the traditional public schools.
What do you say, Joan? Is it a fireable offense to not visit schools that are doing badly and understand why they're doing badly?
No, that's not a fireable offense, but the senator is, okay, she wasn't Secretary of Education in Michigan, but she's been Secretary of Education for a year.
That wasn't the question.
Let me finish. What are you talking about? Why are you filibustering me?
Leslie Stahl asked the question when she was in Michigan, did she visit those schools, and that's what she responded to.
She could have gone to visit them in the year since she's been a Secretary of Education.
She promotes
a particular line on school choice that is often validated by fact. She should be visiting these low-performing schools before she passes judgment on exactly why they're low-performing, and she has not done that. She is an ideologue. She and her husband are behind the notion that we should call public schools government schools to make them sound somehow degraded or like they're from the Soviet Union or something, rather than a place that I personally sent my daughter very proudly. None of her kids went to public schools. So the idea that this woman is actually the Secretary of Education is an affront to a lot of American parents, and she should have done her job to prepare for that interview. Leslie did not back her into a corner or do anything unfair. She did her job. It's Betsy DeVos who did not do her job.
I tell you what's an affront to American parents is a 50% illiteracy rate in the city of Detroit. That's an affront. We have public schools that are failing, and you had someone who was trying to do something about it and to try to break up the monopoly among public schools, and that's why people hate her so much.
All right. Thank you both very much. And next, Russia blamed for poisoning.